So how did I end up as an urban designer? Well, when I look back on it, it all feels fairly natural. I mean, I can remember being a kid and just drawing skylines all day. Like, all I wanted to do was draw cities and draw landmarks and places that I'd never been to. I was just always fascinated with different cities and different places that I knew I wanted to travel to one day. And I actually did get that chance. When I was in architecture school, I got to go and live in two cities in Europe, Copenhagen, Denmark, and Porto, Portugal. And Copenhagen just pretty much blew my mind because I'd never been in a place where so many people were choosing to ride their bikes to pretty much anywhere they needed to go. And then when I was in Portugal, I was so enamored with public spaces, these public squares, and I would sit there for hours and I would just observe people, you know. So I went to my academic advisor and I told him, this is my trajectory, this is what I want to do. And he was like, well, I do research and I work as an inclusive urbanist. I look at the design of cities, how they look, how they function, thinking about the future, thinking about what makes cities resilient. Would you want to do some work with me? And I said, yeah, why not? That sounds pretty interesting. So, you know, when I look back on all of this, I would just say that, you know, as you're pursuing a career, and it may be in the architecture and planning field, or it may be in something else, keep some flexibility and try new opportunities. And if things come your way, you know, maybe take them as I did. And, you know, and make sure that you're passionate about this too. And that's how I became an urban designer.